Lord Bath was one of the most eccentric characters British high society has ever seen and was famed for his raunchy antics over the years. The wealthy aristocrat, who was the 7th Marquess of Bath, died in hospital yesterday after battle with coronavirus. He was 87. As the owner of Longleat Safari Park in Wiltshire, he had an estimated fortune of £157 million at the time of his death and was most famous for his rampant love life, boasting of his sexual prowess. He racked up 74 girlfriends he referred to as his wifelets, and earned himself the nickname the Loins of Longleat. Lord Bath is said to have housed his consorts at cottages across his vast estate, amid rumors of group sex and parties descending into drunken orgies at the stately home. Back in 2011, one of the wifelets spoke out and lifted the lid on debauched luncheon at Longleat, which descended into chaos as three of the women fought over who would get to sleep with the Marquess. Wifelets retired Mauritian model Trudy Juggernaut, Sharma, who had been wifelet number 68 for more than 13 years, explained the women clashed in jealous rage. She claimed it started after she retired to the penthouse with Lord Bath and Susanna Zaleski, non, wifelet who met him after having fling with number 54, the late singer Jo Lane. Trudy said they were interrupted by another of Lord Bath's regular consorts, Irish singer Amanda Doyle, who claimed to have spent 10 years as wifelet trying to have baby with him via IFV. After blazing row, which was eventually calmed down, Trudy claimed Amanda burst in again and attacked her. The bloody brawl ended with the police being called. During an interview with the Daily Mail, Trudy explained why so many women found Lord Bath so attractive. She said, "He's wonderful man. From the moment met him thought he looked fantastic, so deadly, but so beautifully deadly. He walked with real swagger, comfortable and confident with himself, and he spoke so nicely because he's Eton and Oxford educated." Porno art Lord Bath, who spent his later years on crutches, also famously conveyed his saucy tastes onto the walls of Longleat in his Kama Sutra. He was an enthusiastic amateur painter and adorned the walls of his residence with pornographic images inspired by the Indian sex book, as well as displaying his erotic art all over his lavish home. He often boasted about his sexual prowess, many lovers insisting that even in his later years, he had no need for Viagra. He said of the pill, "I've tried Viagra, but didn't find it as useful as would have hoped. Just rely on myself to get my own steam." Estate troubles. Lord Bath relinquished control of the estate to his son Cialan, Viscount Weymouth, back in 2010. During his reign there he famously built life size recreation of Stonehenge, launched branch of Holiday Village Centre Parks in Longleat Forest, and filmed TV show there. The BBC's Animal Park featured Ben Fogle and Kate Humble capturing daily life at the safari park. His attempts to run nightclub called Oscars on the estate ended in disaster as the venue was closed down due to problems with violence and drugs. Family feud. Viscount Weymouth is the heir to estate, along with his wife Emma, who competed on Strictly Come Dancing last year. Her appearance on the show was marred by rumors of bad behavior backstage by her husband. Viscount Weymouth was claimed to have had number of backstage tantrums, and was even pictured urinating on wheelie bin outside the studios. The couple married in 2013, but the union caused bitter family feud that tore the aristocrats apart. Both Lord Bath and Viscount Weymouth's mother Anna Thin were said to have been against the marriage and even boycotted the wedding in protest. They faced allegations of racism amid rumors the tensions in the family were due to Emma's skin color. The couple will now continue to run the estate after Lord Bath's death, with Cialan inheriting his title to become the 8th Marquess of Bath.